Crystal, can you give me a cinnamon heart?
Can't you just build a robot to do that for you?
Hey everyone, Jason here. Last year, LEGO released a new robotics programming kit called the Boost, and I finally found some time to build something with it. With February here and Valentine's Day coming up, we had some cinnamon hearts around the house, and I thought it would be a fun challenge to try and build a catapult to launch them at us while we were sitting on the couch. And as you saw in the introduction, it actually worked out surprisingly well. So let's take a look at how it works. There's a hopper at the top of the machine, which has a hole at the bottom, so the cinnamon hearts can fall through onto the conveyor belt, which is driven through these gears here from one of the internal motors of the hub. And the conveyor belt transports the cinnamon hearts into this channel, where they fall into a hole underneath the light sensor. And the light sensor detects when a cinnamon heart is present to stop the conveyor belt, so that in theory you only get one cinnamon heart at a time. That hole is part of a shuttle that moves back and forth, which is controlled through the external motor here. And the shuttle actually performs two tasks. The first is that it pushes the cinnamon heart onto the catapult to load it up. And the second is that it launches the catapult when it retracts. And hopefully I can find that later. The catapult actually works through the coordinated effort of three separate mechanisms. The first are these elastic bands here, which actually store the energy used to fire the catapult. And we can see them in action if we just manually fire it. The second is this lever here, which actually pushes the catapult down, and it's driven from the other internal motor of the hub through these gears here, which gear it down enough to actually be able to do it. It actually takes quite a bit of force to push the catapult down. And the third, of course, is the shuttle, which holds the catapult down while the lever retracts and then releases the catapult to fire it. And we can see all that in action here. So when we put all that together, whenever you want a cinnamon heart, you can just run the program and it will trigger the entire sequence. Oh, missed. I will be posting building instructions for this model hopefully within the next week, and you'll be able to find those over at jkbrickworks.com as usual. I might also make a building video for this, just so it's a little more clear how it all goes together. All the pieces you need to build this come in the Boost, so if you have this set, you'll be able to build it. Except for the cinnamon hearts, of course. And if you're not a big fan of cinnamon hearts, you can probably repurpose it for any small candy. You might just have to change a few things, like the hopper and maybe how the light is mounted, just to accommodate whatever you put in it. I had a lot of fun building this model and playing around with the Boost. There's a lot of things I like about it, and some things not so much, but I'll save that for another video. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you next time. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Again!
Okay.
There was two!
Okay, hold on.
My new cinnamon hearts.
Okay. I know. We've got some issues right now.
God, hurt my tooth.